Welcome to This Just In, a weekly news show highlighting the people and events in Newport News Public Schools where students receive a well-rounded education and a variety of hands-on experiences needed to succeed in life. Fourth and fifth grade students in Nelson Elementary's Leadership Club have focused their efforts on raising awareness and supporting the prevention of child abuse. For over a month, students advertised and sold caregrams, giving students, teachers, and parents a chance to share kind and encouraging words with one another. From the money collected through selling caregrams and with a match donation from Principal Dr. Melody Camp, the students and staff at Nelson raised enough money to host their own mini silent garden in front of the school during April, which is Child Abuse Prevention Month. The silent garden is a visual representation of the silent victims of child abuse. Professional school counselor Christina Buckingham and assistant principal Jeff Armstrong assisted the 40 leadership students to set up the wooden silhouettes and plant 250 pinwheels, which is the national uplifting symbol for child abuse prevention that reflects hope, health, and safety. Nelson was one of two schools recognized for their efforts by the Newport News Healthy Families Initiative Advisory Board, who coordinates these events every year. Nelson's leadership students also participated in the opening ceremony for the 7th annual Newport News Silent Children's Garden at Boulevard Park, located on the corner of Warwick and J. Clyde Morris Boulevards. The young students read some of the statistics about child abuse and neglect that happen every day, while the garden itself encouraged positive parenting tips, such as reading together, listening to children, and eating meals as a family. JROTC cadets from Minchville High School presented the colors and led attendees and elected officials in the Pledge of Allegiance. For the students at Nelson, this level of involvement allowed them to connect deeply to an important cause and realize the impact they can have together to create a positive community. First graders at Yates Elementary took a huge step in helping their community. For months, these young students have been collecting canned food and boxed meals as part of their annual iCare project. Through iCare, students investigate a need in their community, create a plan, put it into action, reflect on what they've accomplished, and finally, exhibit their results. With hunger being a very real need in our community, the first grade students decided to collect food to donate to the Virginia Peninsula Food Bank. Teachers kept the students motivated by using the canned goods in different classroom activities that reinforced counting patterns, place value, and sorting. And when students turned in their monthly home reading calendar, many brought in cans at the same time. The students worked together to bring in their final donation, and they used their growing math skills to figure out the fastest way to count the entire collection, which was counting by tens. With Donna Tai, the community relations manager from the food bank, looking on, the first graders organized, counted, and then boxed the entire donation. Tai thanked the students for collecting 154 pounds of food and stressed how important this donation was to helping families across Hampton Roads. By completing their iCare project, the young students at Yates showed how much they've learned about helping others. Our students are leaders, and they have a positive influence on our community.
This is my future.
This is my future.
My future.
My future.
I'm building my future
every day.
And while many help shape this future,
parents, teachers,
friends, mentors,
this future will always be mine. So I take ownership.
I take ownership.
Responsibility.
And I will seize every opportunity
to make the most of my future.
And right now,
right now,
right now,
I'm building my future.
I'm building my future.
And becoming college, career, and citizen ready.
In Newport News Public Schools. In Newport News Public Schools, I'm empowered and encouraged to be successful academically and socially. Through a variety of youth development opportunities, I am growing as a leader and a citizen. The teachers I've had over the years are a huge reason for my success, and many of them go an extra mile every day. When they're not teaching me about math, English, and science during the school day, They're teaching me about life after school. Clubs with a focus on mentoring create a positive and supportive environment for students to succeed. To have my teachers invest in me as a person and not just as a student is so rewarding. It motivates me to work harder in school and at home.
And the example our teacher set forth has inspired me and many of my friends to pass it on to our own classmates. In both middle and high schools, we have a great opportunity to mentor our peers, including younger students. We're able to share our experiences, studying tips, and other strategies for succeeding in school. We even mentor some of the youngest students in our city at the early childhood centers in elementary schools. Whether we're reading a book together or just sharing interests, mentoring is rewarding for everyone. The younger students get some extra attention while also looking forward to some fun experiences as they grow up. And for us older students, we really enjoy the benefit of giving back and having the opportunity to visit our old schools and catch up with some favorite teachers.
And what a great city we live in, where our community gets involved in mentoring also. Volunteers from the military, local businesses, community partners, churches, and even colleges help out every week. These individuals and teams bring their life, career, and academic experiences to the table. Sometimes these connections create internships, job shadowing opportunities, summer jobs, or even future careers. Sometimes we get to work alongside these remarkable people, learning practical skills hand in hand.
These partners and mentors coming into our schools have inspired us to give back to the community. Get ready for a pretty extensive list here, because students in Newport News never take a break. Every day, my classmates can be found donating food or money to those in need in Hampton Roads, using our art skills to raise money for local organizations, visiting retirement communities to spread some holiday cheer, collecting clothes, jackets, and shoes during the cold winter months, digging deep to keep our neighborhoods looking good, ringing bells during the holidays for the Salvation Army, plunging into freezing cold water to raise money for Special Olympics Virginia, creating custom holiday cards for servicemen and women, spending time with wounded soldiers who fought bravely for our country, rebuilding computers to give away to families, or volunteering our time at local races to raise money for a number of causes.
And when we're back at school, we always find ways to help out. We collect and recycle cans, plant seasonal flowers, and do what we can to make our schools look beautiful. We watch each other's backs, reminding our friends to buckle up in a car.
Here's what it all boils down to.
Whether we're being mentored or offering the mentorship,
whether we're collecting money or dishing out warm meals,
it might be volunteering on the weekend
or extra hours after school,
it's seen through our actions.
It's how and what we're taught.
It's part of who we are now and in the future.
It all boils down to leadership.
We're not becoming leaders.
We are leaders.
We are leaders.
We are leaders.
Right now and every day.
Every club we're a member of, every adult that inspires us, every choice we make is helping us to become confident leaders. Many times, it's my friends and classmates that come up with these great ideas to make our schools and communities better. We've been empowered by the teachers and staff in our schools to think creatively, take initiative, and make a real impact in our schools. Through our involvement in clubs, athletics, and community service, we've learned responsibility, respect, collaboration, and perseverance.
We are leading.
We are leading.
We are serving.
We are serving.
We are achieving every day.
And we are
college,
career,
and citizen ready.
Recently, our students' efforts through youth development initiatives were recognized at an awards luncheon honoring middle and high school students from across Newport News Public Schools. 126 students received the 2016 Star Award for students taking action and responsibility. Principals and other school staff drape medals around their students' necks for setting shining examples as growing leaders, contributing citizens, and working within teams to impact their schools and our community in positive ways. These students represented 42 different clubs, student organizations, and sports teams from each of their middle and high schools. Youth development is one of the three goals that the Newport News School Board has set for every student to obtain through the district-wide academic agenda. While still stressing the importance of succeeding academically, Newport News Public Schools understands the importance of developing well-rounded students who possess multiple skills and the experiences needed to succeed in life. The Secondary Star Awards Luncheon was hosted entirely by students from middle and high schools in Newport News, who introduced speakers, shared each school's accomplishments, and offered their own insights and experiences as they've grown through Newport News Public Schools. Thanks for joining us for this week's edition of This Just In. And check out more fun and informative videos at nnpstv.com to see the many great things happening in Newport News Public Schools. Thanks for watching.